What is the difference between a CO2 laser and an erbium laser? So let's talk about the similarities first. So they are both ablative lasers, meaning they both burn the skin in a controlled fashion. The target of both the lasers, or the chromophore, is water, which is everywhere, which means it's not specific to any certain type of tissue, since water is in all of our tissue and both of these laser beams target water. They're rather non-specific and they are ablative lasers that will burn the skin, which is what we want. Erbium is a little more precise and specific when it comes to the absorption by water. So some people believe that the erbium laser is more controlled and safer. But in all reality, the degree of safety and control has a lot more to do with the way the device is programmed and who is using it compared to the difference between a CO2 laser beam or an erbium laser beam. In our office, I have an erbium laser, which is highly controlled and customizable, meaning I can actually dial in a precise depth to the millionth of a meter, and that gives me the control to ablate and burn the skin to achieve the results that people want with a high degree of safety. So in other words, if I didn't have that level of control and precision, I would have to be a lot more conservative to avoid causing any harm. And that would mean a lot of people would have underwhelming and unsatisfactory results. But because the erbium laser is tunable and precise and very controlled, we are able to do more aggressive treatments safely, which gives people a better result and more improvement while still maintaining safety due to the high degree of precision and control that our erbium laser has. So, to break it down, erbium laser, CO2 laser, they're both ablative lasers that target water in the tissues to burn the tissues. It's a controlled burn to treat wrinkles and smooth out the skin. And how, I guess, safe they are and how predictable and controlled they are has more to do with the actual laser itself and who is using or controlling the laser. To learn more, check out our website where you can upload your photos and concerns as a virtual consult. You can also check out our price estimator to get pricing information for all the various procedures we offer. And finally, if you'd like to have your questions answered on a future podcast or Q&A video session like this, please leave a message on our SpeakPipe. You can go to our blog page and our SpeakPipe is located there. Thanks for listening.